Well, you finished your first study in Gripped by the Greatness of God. We've been learning about holiness, and I trust the study and the discussion has been a blessing and an encouragement to you. But if I was sitting where you're sitting, especially as we're just getting to know each other, I'd be wondering to myself, man, is this happening in his life? Is he just talking to me about stuff, or is this really going on for him? And I want you to know that I have been gripped by the holiness of God numerous times throughout my life in ministry, but I want to tell you about a time where this happened powerfully for me. It came after 10 years of grueling, difficult, challenging ministry. I was exhausted, and I thank God for the grace that he showed me and my elders who had the sense that they needed to send us away for a little time of refreshment, and I had to regroup. And by God's grace, we were on the south coast of France, a place I never expected to be, along a shore, really just about like this. My family was sleeping. I got up early in the morning, and I had a bucket full of questions I had to bring before God. I wanted to go back to ministry, but things could not be the same. And as I walked and listened to scripture through some headphones, I'll tell you what, God showed up, but not in the way that I thought. Not with the comforting, encouraging, fatherly presence that we experience so often. Instead, God showed up with a powerful view of his holiness. I'd been surfacing some of my questions. Why are people like this? Why are they so harsh and so hurtful? Not the majority, but the minority that can push you and pressure you so powerfully in ministry. And I had to have some answers to the perplexities that I was feeling. So as I poured out my questions to God, like I said, he showed up, but not the way that I thought. I had an encounter with the holiness of God like I've never experienced before, and God had some questions for me. Who are you to always be pointing your finger at others? Who are you to be asking all these harsh questions and judging others for the way they treat you? Are you living up to everything that you preach? Are you everything that you teach the scriptures command us to be? No, you're not, James. And all I can tell you is in a matter of a few moments, I got up from the water and found a place behind some rocks and poured out some tears of honest confession to the Lord. I'll tell you, when you encounter the holiness of God, you don't have a lot of questions about other people. You realize how very far short we all fall. Well, I've had my ups and downs since then, but I'll tell you, I was changed on that beach that day. A personal encounter with the holiness of God. When you see that standard, when you know what he's calling for from all of us, you don't have a lot of energy for pointing fingers and wondering about others. We're all falling so very far short of this holiness, but isn't it awesome that he calls us to it? I'm going to be praying for you this week as you dig into God's Word and study yourself about the holiness of God. Praying that you'll be gripped, not just because it's taught in Scripture, but because it happened to me. How great is our God.